How do I feel about the Star Wars sequel trilogy? This is a question that I get asked quite a bit as well. And, you know, I enjoy it. I enjoy it for what it is. Are there things that I disagree with? Are there things that, you know, aren't my favorite? Absolutely. Because there is no perfect movie, no matter what. Like, you can always make a better movie. But, you know, I will share my perspective on certain things that I would like to share with, you know, my following and folks who are part of the fandom. So, I'll backtrack. I will say, you know, in terms of rating the movies, my favorite is The Last Jedi, and then second to that would be Rise of Skywalker. My least favorite is Force Awakens for some reason. I don't know, it just feels like a lot, like a copy and paste New Hope to me. And I think that's part of why I didn't enjoy that one as much. That's just me. But Last Jedi and Rise of Skywalker, yes, hands down, I absolutely enjoy those movies. And visually, they are some of the best of the Star Wars movies, period. Like, they are eye candy to watch, man. They are simply eye candy. So I definitely enjoy, those are definitely my top two in terms of the sequel trilogy. Now, one thing I would like to share, because I get asked about this a lot, I remember when The Last Jedi came out, and The Rise of Skywalker. I remember watching different movie reviewers and other YouTubers and content creators that, you know, would do reviews and that you know, I still trust, you know, to this day, and that I still value, but I would listen to their reviews first, listen to their opinions first, before I went to go see the movie, before I read the content, before I watched the content for myself. And that got me in such a dangerous spot is because I was so heavily dependent on, you know, somebody else's opinion before forming my own. And so after, you know, rewatching, you know, the movies and seeing things for myself, I remember when I came out of The Rise of Skywalker, because I remember that everyone was like bashing it and saying how terrible it was, and they can't believe that Star Wars has gotten to this point. And I'm like, damn, man, this has got to be crazy. What happened? And so I remember going to see it for myself and then coming out of the theater. I was like, are people getting paid to bash Star Wars? Because I'm like, it isn't as bad as some people were making it to seem. That's just my opinion. I know there are other hardcore fans out there who will pick apart other little details and say like, hey, there's this and that I just didn't really like. And there are some of you who have a better eye for things in film that I can understand. You know what I mean? Like, if there are certain things that you're looking at, like, you know, I can see things from a filming perspective where certain things just didn't match up. I totally get that, and I value people's opinions that don't like the sequels. I totally get it. You know, I'm not bashing anyone at all. But, you know, for me, my perspective is I was in a dangerous spot personally where I was just listening to other people's opinions first before forming my own opinion, going to, you know, watch the content, going to read a book first before listening to anyone else. You know, and that's one of the things I encourage most, you know, for my following is like, hey, you can listen to my opinion, that's fine, but go watch this stuff first for yourself and have your own opinion and then come and discuss with me and share, you know, your thoughts and see if our thoughts align. And if they don't, that's great too, you know, because it's great. You get to learn from other people's perspectives. And so to answer the question, that's kind of how I feel about the sequel trilogy. Like, you know, you could always make a better movie. There could always be a better, you know, trilogy, but we got what we got. I've even heard people go as far as to, like, I made a comparison of this in one of my lives where someone was, someone that I follow that compared the sequel trilogy to Dragon Ball Z in the sense that for anime fans, you know, there's Dragon Ball Z, and then years ago we had Dragon Ball GT, which some fans liked and some fans didn't. You know, it was a continuation after Z. And then, you know, just a few years, you know, ago, we had Dragon Ball Super, which was a new continuation after Dragon Ball Z. And some fans are saying, you know, the Star Wars world is like, that's what Lucasfilm and Disney should do with the sequel trilogy. It's treated like Dragon Ball GT. It's like Legends, for instance. Like, that could be Legends lore, but it not necessarily canonized. And, like, that's not gonna happen. You know, everything that they're doing on Disney Plus, like, that's not too retcon, you know, the sequel trilogy. But, you know, my opinion is we got what we got. It is what it is. The best thing that we can do is move forward. And hopefully, you know, folks who are behind the creative part of things can learn from certain things and say, you know what? You know, we see where, you know, maybe not necessarily having a full plan can kind of backfire. So let's move forward and do better going forward. You know what I mean? So that's where I'm at with it. But ultimately, the more Star Wars content we got, I enjoy it, man. And that's just my opinion. I enjoy what we got. It is what it is. The best thing we can do is just move forward in a positive light. If you guys enjoyed this video, be sure to thumbs up. If you're new to the channel, be sure to subscribe as well. And I will see you for the next video. This is the way.